A lawsuit has been filed against Amazon, accusing the company of selling what they're calling suicide kits to teenagers. Parents of 16-year-old Kristine, 17-year-old Ethan say that the Amazon platform assisted in the deaths of the two minors by selling them sodium nitrite. But specifically, it's not just that they are selling that product, it's the purity of the product combined with some of the recommendations that Amazon was making. So some sodium nitrite being sold on Amazon is of such a high purity that they say ingesting a single teaspoon will almost certainly be fatal. And the complaint filed claims that Amazon recommended that customers who purchase the chemical also buy a scale to measure the correct dose, an anti-vomiting drug that potentially would keep it in their system to do the damage, and Amazon's edition of a handbook on assisted suicide. Okay, attorneys for those involved in the lawsuit, one says Amazon is selling a product that is as deadly as cyanide. And the point that they're trying to make here is not that Amazon is selling something that can be used for suicide. There are many things on Amazon that can be used for suicide. They say this is different from selling rope or knives or something else like this. Selling it at this purity appears to only be good for this use. And so they're looking to either stop that and potentially get some justice for the deaths that they experienced. So JR, I know this is crazy. I can already see from the comments that I don't think anyone predicted that this would happen or saw Amazon being involved in this. But what do you think about it?
But what's the excuse then? What is the reason? If again, all these details about the degree to which this can be sold, this potency or this level that only has one use. So what is the reasoning, right? There's things that are deadly. You can't go to your local CVS and get certain kinds of cold medicines right now because of what's in it, unless you're of certain age and they know what's happening with it and what your potential use for it might be, because it could harm you, right? But why is this different? Is this brand new? Is this something no one's ever heard of before? Because again, those cold medicines, they had to be a bit of people coming together to say, hey, these are causing this kinds of harm. Let's make sure that the folks who get their hands on it, it's harder to, or we'll find out what their reasons are or how much it could be spread. Where's that process in this story?
I would love to know. What I've been able to find is that Congress did, they sent a letter to the CEO of Amazon. Amazon has said they've responded to the congressional inquiry privately. We don't know exactly what. They also say that when people search suicide on the platform, a banner with the phone number for the National Suicide Prevention Hotline appears. And they say we extend our deepest condolences to the families and loved ones personally affected by suicide. They say that there are other legitimate reasons for it to be on the platform. It's legal and widely available. Okay. I mean, it's just so sad. It's obviously very easily accessible at a very high purity that I am led to believe is not easily available for other people. Then when you combine it with the recommendations, which look, I understand that algorithms are probably generating that, but I don't know. I don't know.
I know we live in a world, a country where anybody who does something wrong or facilitates wrongdoing is seen as like trying to make it happen. So fine, let's go with the giving you the benefit of the doubt, Amazon. You didn't want this. This wasn't what you're doing it for. You're sad about these folks that have killed themselves based off of what they used, right? So change policy. If nothing else, it's a marketing thing. Change the way you do it so that it won't be so easy. Now that it's been talked about, why is that hard?
Yeah. Well, and look, they certainly want to reassure us that they care about the safety of their customers. So hopefully they will be amenable to making some changes. Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.